Good evening, Sacred Grounds.
Good evening.
Back when John F. Kennedy was still alive and I was entering high school, I made the acquaintance of a fellow named Ken Okuno. This is a picture of him, approximately 19 years old, and you can imagine that he's a little grayer now. When a Berkeley musician gets to be a certain age, his friends may feel it necessary to get together and fry his ass. This was my contribution to such a gathering for my friend. It's called Jigsaw. With a name like Okuno, he has to be an Irishman. He talks of green plums and poetry, and his birthday is so close to St. Paddy's Day that you could beat him with a stick. I've seen him take many forms, a skylark flitting about the court, holding with a tennis racket, a salty dog playing electric guitar. I have seen him mad as a Van Gogh, drawing froggy guts as I cut them up in biology lab. I have run with him as the three-quarter moon stared down at us like an angry eye, floating over Terminal Island breakwater, wild night of roving poet gang, each on the edge of heartbreak. Hey, Jack, what's in the box? Alan, you missed your calling. Really? Yeah. Sweet! Lukewarm chocolate down the back of neck, honorary membership in the Half a Key Club. Yale mania, Doomsbury crazy, stuffing flowers into gun barrels at the Pentagon while Pasadena went up in flashes from the left and was destroyed by the fire from the right. Snow crisp flakes and New York saltine dreams, reaching immortal intensity of emotion and jotting it down while watching Captain Kangaroo. Calculus blues turned to Berkeley in a bottle. Atlanta prodigal son returns to basement zen to the appreciation of simplicity in a detachable Volkswagen engine. It may seem odd that for a Pasadena boy, the soul is in the snow. The tracks to its inner mystery in the high Sierras are guarded by a dragon moon haze that can only be seen through the windows of a Volkswagen bus. Which is the reality? Can you hear the crunching break the silence of the snow? Perhaps it is the crystallization that elevates the thought, that drives the symbolic self above the tepidity of the flesh. Orange blood paints the surface of the snow. Magenta blood forms rivulets that join the icy waters. Green blood forms the next generation. Captain Kangaroo once galloped in, bringing green plums seared in a hot wok. He laughed with his friend Barney the Dragon until the smell of hot peanut oil melted the snow and we began to see the ghosts underneath. You understand that none of these can touch my tuna casserole. As I recall, the entire city of Berkeley refused to touch my tuna casserole. But then, that is a different piece of the puzzle. After El Nino, the snow keeps melting, revealing Dodger Stadium underneath, celebrating the return of Buddha in the form of Fernando Valenzuela. While a saxophone plays over the stadium loudspeaker, Buddha winds up and throws. Jesus wanted to sacrifice to get Okuno home. Instead, Jesus is hit by the pitch. Jesus forgives Buddha. Buddha falls down laughing on the pitcher's mound. In the midst of all the confusion, Okuno scores the winning run. The game is over. The game has just begun. The game continues. It is the sign of the laughing Buddha, signaling a time for swimming naked under the moonlight in the pool at the Huntington Sheraton Hotel. It is the raw audacity of the act that guarantees its success. It is the three-quarter moon staring down, this time with a laughing eye, like some giant spirit that is awakened by whiskey and music passed around at his wake. These legends, we believe, are all true. For that, I'll lift my glass to ye and call for blessing from the motley fool. I cannot pretend to understand the movement of the jigsaw as it carves out these pieces. I can only savor the beauty of each piece as it falls upon the table.
Wow.